took you on a breathtaking trip for the ultimate adventure.
The Bikini Open!
Yeah! Come join us for the most exotic experience of your life.
It's the Bikini Open 3, the ultimate adventure.
Three times as hot.
Three times the men!
Three times the women!
Three times the fun!
Welcome to the Bikini Open 3!
I'm Colette.
I'm Holly.
I'm Donna.
I'm Michael.
And I'm Mercedes.
We showed you 8 exciting women's contests and 4 sizzling men's contests.
Welcome to Jamaica, man.
Never find anywhere like this on Earth. Never.
Jamaica is real nice. It's a paradise.
Welcome to Jamaica.
The sun, the fun, and the rum.
Great place.
This is a great adventure.
Jamaica is just a paradise, a gem in the world. It's incredible. I love it.
Welcome to Jamaica!
Jamaica, and we're at Hedonism 2, the ultimate place for the ultimate adventure.
Hedonism 2 is a holiday for the mind, the body, the spirit, and the soul. One thing sums it up is that at the end of your vacation, if you did everything we had to offer at Hedonism 2, you'd need a vacation from your vacation.
What do you think?
I think we're going to have a great contest today. I got to look at the girls backstage, Mercedes, and they are hot.
Ultimate adventure for him. Here we go.
Are you ready? Are you with me? Are you ready for the ladies backstage? Ladies and gentlemen, the first contestant coming down here this afternoon is no other than Delaine Mann. Out of South Carolina.
Michael's not calling his ultimate adventure here in Jamaica until he's seen all the women out here on stage.
I tell you, Mercedes, you got to see them for a good 1-2 minutes up there dancing each. You really get to get their whole personality comes through.
Next we call Cynthia.
Great pucker, suit. It gives her a little extra something.
Yeah, she's got a very, very thin body, very toned, and looks good out there.
If she drives you crazy, make some noise.
She's really driving the guys crazy.
That was Cynthia. Come on, let's hear it for the lady. Next we call Natasha.
Oh, here's Miss Jamaica looking hot. Oh, God, she is hot.
She came out with a prop, something extra to get the crowd going. She's in a bright, hot red suit, tea bag, and she's very, very pretty. She's got a great body.
Oh, and she's got that, definitely has the native flair.
Miss Jamaica. Oh. Next we call Donna. Donna out of Jamaica.
What do you think about her?
She's definitely a real natural beauty. Real natural looks. We saw her this morning. She looks great out in the sun. Definitely a Jamaican flower.
And this is paradise.
Oh, yes. Once more, ladies and gentlemen, let's hear it for the Lady Donna. Oh. Next we call Angela.
This was a typical hedonism girl. She's got a little sparkle on her cheek. She's been a good sport all week, Mike, don't you think?
Oh yeah, lots of spunk, lots of spunk.
She's just out here to have a great time. She's got a lot of spirit.
Next is all, Marsha out of Jamaica.
She's got the reggae action down, Michael. She's got those hips going, showing us how to do definite native dance, reggae.
Yeah, she's obviously had years and years of reggae practice. A real reggae natural.
Marsha out of Jamaica. So we're gonna call Catherine. Catherine, guys!
Catherine's got a great body too. She's got one of the best bodies that we'll see here today, Michael. She's in the guys with that little sarong skirt, getting into the native Jamaican action.
Oh yeah, the sarong look was great when she comes out. Then when she took it off, the guys just went wild.
Catherine! Next, we call Charm out of Jamaica.
Here goes Charm, Michael. Tell us about how you found her and got her to enter this contest today.
Well, she just, shall we say, charmed the pants off of us at Rick's Cafe. We just saw her across the floor. Instantly, we were attracted to her, struck up a great conversation, and now she's in the contest.
Next, we call Nadia. Oh, yes.
Hot doesn't even begin to describe this girl's body and this girl's look.
She's got a wonderful suit on. She's got one of the best suits we've seen here today. It's tropical, it's floral, it's bright green and purple. She just took that little skirt off, threw it right to the guys.
Yeah, she's certainly one big plus is she knows how to play to the crowd of guys. I mean, she got them going instantly, and that's got to be worth points with the judges.
Next we call Tanya.
The crowd is going wild for Tanya. Where is she from, Michael?
I don't know. Is she from Jamaica?
She's a California girl down here in Jamaica.
Oh, yeah, Los Angeles, California. Attends Western Michigan University. We've seen a lot of those Western Michigan students on our spring break trip. They are wild.
Next we call Melissa.
She looks great out there. She's really giving the crowd a run for their money. She's a brave girl to get out there among this stiff competition.
Yeah, I think she's doing a great job.
Once more. Come on, bring it up for Melissa.
Michael, we have a really stiff competition here today. It's going to be a very tight race.
Ladies and gentlemen, we are ready. Our third place winner going to none other than Nadia. Oh, third place winner. And second position, ladies and gentlemen, we have the Lady Donna. Donna, are you ready? Make some noise. Ladies and gentlemen, our first place winner is no other than Catherine. Catherine. No other than Catherine. Our first place winner, ladies and gentlemen, Catherine.
I was really surprised I won. I'm very pleased though. I'm French and American Indian, and I've been raised in Florida most of my life. I've been modeling since I was 15, and I work in Canada and throughout the States, and I'm venturing in Japan, and that's where I'm hoping to get this year and do a lot of work in Japan. I'm 5'9" and I'm 36, 26, 35. Physical fitness is very important to me. I have a degree in health, and I used to teach for 3 years at a local university in Daytona Beach. My ideal man would have to be, I think, someone with a lot of ambition, someone going somewhere. I think I like dark men. I like tall, dark, with a mustache, personally, with big muscles.
Hi, I'm Catherine Calafiore, and please vote for me for the Bikini Open.
High diving is dangerous. That's why I'm doing it, because I'm that kind of guy.
What?
This is my ultimate adventure.
It's 4 feet. And it's a little dangerous, as the sign says up there, you know? Because sometimes some people are not used to it, and they come and they like jump and they do belly flops and stuff, and that hurts like hell, you know? Yeah, man.
I'm not doing this.
Hey, don't be a chicken, man. Just go out here and jump, man.
Do you see how long? It's miles down there.
You just got to do it quick. You can't look down,
man. It's not so scary once you've jumped. It's just when you stood up there looking at it down, that's when it is scary.
Oh, no.
I usually wear glasses, and so I don't really have much depth perception without them. So it was just like jumping into blue.
Divers are very exciting. We have a lot of brave people. We have local divers that are very good. They do the backflips, one and a half off the tall cliff. And we have the tourists drink a couple rum punch and they take their jump off to say they jumped the ricks. And it's just been a traditional sunset point.
Stay tuned for our next adventure!
Okay, now it's time for the Mr. Hedonism 2 Men's Bikini Contest. Donna, you took a look at some of the guys. What do you think?
Well, we've got biceps, triceps, and a whole lot of muscle, Howie. It's going to be a good contest.
Let's go check it out.
Now, ladies, are you ready? Are you sure you're ready? Well, let's do it out, Miles. We want you back, Miles. Out of California, coming down to Strutney Stone.
Ow!
Give me more, give me more. What goodies do you have in store for us, Curtis? Oh, yes. Right about now, we're going to be waiting for our judges. And are you ready for the big number one? And it goes to the man out of Canada, Curtis!
You were a landslide winner. What did you have that everyone else didn't have?
You know, I don't really know. I just went out there to have some fun and was hoping that the girls would appreciate it. Obviously, they did and gave me a little extra.
I'm 20 years old. I'm 6'1". I'm a professional hockey player up in Canada in Quebec City. I wanted to be like Wayne Gretzky, and he's my childhood hero. Hockey is very physical, it's demanding, and that's the kind of sports I like. It's very competitive, and I'm a pretty competitive person myself, and I enjoy that kind of stuff, and just getting out and having some fun with some friends, that's another aspect I enjoy. I would say I'm a pretty shy person. I don't think I would describe myself as sexy. I just try to be myself and do whatever comes to my mind. Hi, I'm Curtis, electrician from Quebec City, Canada. Vote for me in the Bikini Open.
And coming up next,
Reggae Mon.
Reggae Mon.
The limbo dancing now. It takes physical fitness from your abdomen and your leg muscles. You have to be real strong.
Jamaica is the number one spot for reggae music.
Ladies section, ladies and gentlemen, let's hear it for Gail out of England.
It was a lot of fun. I just went out and had a good time. and I enjoyed myself really, and obviously did the trick. Physically, well, I'm 5'5", 36, 23, 35. I was born in Liverpool, born and raised, and went to school there and everything. And then when I was 16, I started modelling.
We have a newspaper called The Sun that I work for a lot. I remember the first time I went in The Sun, that's like the whole page three girls things, you know, you guys are like Samantha Fox and stuff.
My ideal man would be tall, dark, handsome, great sense of humour. Find someone who wants to do what I want to do, travel around and take things easy. I mean, life's really short, you know, and you should just have fun while we're here. I can go from extremes, but I like to keep a nice balance on things, keep things in perspective, and not worry too much about things that I've got no control over.
Hi, I'm Gail McKenna. I'm from Liverpool, England, and vote for me on the Bikini Open.
Bikini watching has become America's favorite pastime when it lands on national daytime television. We are backstage at the Sally Jesse Raphael Show for the first annual Bikini Madness contest. And the Bikini Open is a part of it, so here we go!
The Sally Jesse Raphael Show always tackles important subjects on daytime television. So when Sally and her team decided to put on a bikini contest, we checked it out.
We found out the rest of the country was not aware that this was going on, and we thought it would be good, honest to goodness, clean, fun, and we found that women and men love to see great bodies, so why not?
Behind the scenes, lots of great male and female bodies showed up to audition for Sally's first Bikini Madness contest.
We did different carts around the country, and we put an announcement on, if you think you have a nice body, if you want to compete, something like that, please call the Sally Jesse Raphael Show, you know, this phone number. And we heard from all kinds of people, and mainly here in San Diego.
My grandmother told me this was going on, so I decided to come down.
And my mother invited me to this contest. She found out from a friend.
I think it'll be really fun. It's good for my modeling and acting career being on national television.
From one of the Bikini Open contests.
Camera one over here is going to shoot Sally and all the guys, all right? Then the handheld is going to pick up the winner.
It's great fun. More fun than should be allowed on television.
All right, Sally, talk to these people. They are wonderful, they're hot, they're ready to go, aren't you, gang?
We are in beautiful, sunny San Diego, California, and today we are here at the Sally Jesse Raphael Show for the first annual Bikini Madness Contest. I'm with Pamela Paulshock, who is the winner of the Bikini Open 2 Viewer Poll. Pamela, what about the contestants we're going to be seeing today?
I think the girls look great. The guys are really pumped up. Stay with us later in the show.
You won't want to miss it.
Bikini contests, they are taking place all over the country. And Lisa, we're going to do this ourselves today, okay? We're going to have our own bikini contest.
They've asked us. Let's dream for the impossible.
Exactly. Here to help us with our own festivities is a man who emcees these contests all over. Please welcome from Tampa Bay, Florida, Michael Templer.
How's everybody doing out here today? Welcome to the first Sally Jesse Raphael Bikini Madness Contest. We've got six ladies and six men. You are the judges today, so it's up to you to make lots of noise for the contestants you want to win. Ladies, are you ready to see some guys? Guys out there, are you ready to see some beautiful ladies? Let's get busy. Our first contestant from La Jolla. This is Denise Reiser. Denise is 25 years old. She is single. She is a model and part-time cocktail waitress. How about a round of applause for Denise? Contestant number two. Put your hands together for Larry Muirhead from San Diego. Larry is 29 years old, the former Mr. Arizona. Ladies, he is single and he loves it. His hobbies include riding and working out naked. How about a hand for Larry from San Diego? Contestant number three from Point Loma, San Diego. This is Dottie Biddle. She's 28 years old. She's a professional model and currently is Miss Bridgestone Tires. How about a hand for contestant number three, Dottie? Contestant number four from Ocean Beach. This is Tom McBride. Tom is 30 years old. He's single. Contestant number five from Escondido. This is Adrian Clark. Adrian, get this, is 16 years old. She's a student from San Pasqual High School, a cheerleader on the varsity team. Contestant number six from San Diego. This is Steve Harveston. Steve is 28 years old. He is single, not voluntarily though. Ladies, he is a male secretary, and his hobbies include surfing, going to the movies, bodybuilding, and beautiful women. How about a hand for contestant number six, Steve? Contestant number seven from Ramona, California. This is Amber Sommermeyer. Amber's 19 years old. She is single. She works part-time at a law firm. She is also a model. Contestant number eight, this is Dana Towers from South Mission, San Diego. He's 33 years old. He's single. And as you can tell, he has never done one of these contests before. Contestant number nine from San Diego, California. This is Kelly Pender. Kelly is 26 years old. She is single. She has appeared in an MTV video, and she is also a model. Contestant number 10 from Pacific Beach, California. This is Tom Friedman. He's a commercial land broker. Do not buy land from him. It is all swampland. Contestant number 11 from Ramona, California. This is Leslie Bremer. Leslie is 24 years old, single, a professional model, and she owns her own bathing suit company called Hot Pursuit. The suit she is wearing, she designed. And doesn't it look good? How about a hand for contestant number 11, Leslie? Number 12 from West Germany. This is Matthias Granick. Matthias has the inevitable moving pelvis. He is 29 years old. He's single. His hobbies include sports and traveling. And look at him travel. How about a hand for contestant number 12, Matthias? All right, right now what we're going to do is we're going to go through each of the men and the women individually. You make noise for the one you want to win.
All right, gorgeous guy number one, this is Matthias, right?
Matthias.
Matthias, how do you feel about him? Yes, yes, give us what you got, babe. Tom. Dana. For her. Here's Tom. Put your hands together for Larry.
We have Leslie. Next we have Kelly. Amber. Adrian, Dottie, and Denise.
All right, the award, the first annual Sally Jesse Raphael Bikini Madness Contest goes to Steve.
Congratulations.
And for the women, the first annual Sally Jesse Raphael Bikini Madness Contest goes to Leslie.
Leslie, she just won the Sally Jesse Raphael contest. How's it feel? You just won the whole contest.
Oh, it feels great. The girls were great. They were all beautiful, and I think they're all winners.
Steve, you just won the Sally Jesse Raphael contest. What do you think you did to get the crowd going out there?
I think the secret weapon was my wiggling buns, as a matter of fact. You can quote me on that.
I was born and raised in Southern California, San Diego. I'm 28 years old. My measurements, 50, 30, and firm. When I was in high school, I was really small, real small. Working out means training hard, training fast, and being focused on what you're doing. It's hard work. Bikini contest, it's not exploiting anybody. We're doing it because we want to do it, and we are proud of what we've done with our bodies. Hi, I'm Steve Harrison. Vote for me on the Bikini Open. Thank you.
And she just won the entire Sally Jesse Raphael contest. What did you do out there to get the crowd going?
I was just myself, and I wore a bright suit, which helped and a lot of people noticed.
I'm 5'6". I weigh 110 pounds. My measurements are 36, 24, 32. I was born and raised in California. I raised dancing horses, the kind that you see in the circuses. And I have my own bathing suit company called Hot Pursuit. It just merged this year. And we're just having a lot of fun doing that and just showing off the bathing suits at the beach. My sister was beautiful. She won every contest in school. She was Miss Queen this, Miss Queen that in high school. And my mother had a portfolio of her. She's a debutante and never had anything on me. My mother called me the urchin. And every time I'd go down into the living room, I'd see this portfolio. And that made me decide, well, I want to be noticed too. I project myself with class, fun, personality. And I just want to be myself. I'm a tomboy at heart, but at night I'm a woman.
Hi, my name is Leslie Bremer. I'm from Ramona, California, and I hope you vote for me for the Bikini Open.
Can't get much hotter here. But in Copper Mountain, Colorado, the action is real cool.
Totally get rad on it.
Join us at the Bikini Open!
The Bikini Open is cool!
Yeah, the Bikini Open in Colorado is hot.
one, go! We had the Denver Broncos up also this weekend. Several of them were judges this weekend. And we also have a celebrity event with them for a charity that we do every year. We tie that in conjunction with the Eeny Weeny Bikini Contest.
What do the judges look for as far as bikinis go?
I'm not really sure. I'm married, so I can't say too much.
We look real hard, real long, and we're looking for form, and form and response. That's right.
Originality, creativity, and skimpiness.
Oh, yeah. If you can't ski, then you better look good. Yeah.
Well, the reason why for this is so when I get lost, they can find me.
Give me a little bit more information about where you got your hat and why you wear it.
I just found it on the slope, so I whistled and it jumped on my head.
It's bikini open time. Michael, where's the sand? Where are the beaches?
I'll tell you, Donna, we got something extra special today. It's called the Eeny Weeny Bikini Contest here at Copper Mountain in Colorado. And the contestants are going to ski down these slopes right here behind us in their bikinis. Can you believe that?
That sounds hot. Let's go. Right.
Judges, are you ready?
Okay, you have your cards ready? And now, ladies and gentlemen, contestant number one from Philly, from Philadelphia, Pennsylvania. Occupation, he's a leather cleaner. 61 years old. Welcome, please, Otto Kazanjian.
How'd you feel out there today?
Like a sex symbol.
Contestant number two, Corey Loughlad of Silverthorne, Colorado. Occupied as a ski bum. We're going to get a chance to see that bum. He's 27 years old, and here he comes.
What made you wear that?
Sheer lust for exhibitionism.
And you look good out there. What is your strategy coming down the mountain?
I don't know. Bounce.
Go on down, Mark. Mark Ferry from Atco, New Jersey. He's an electrician. All right.
What made you wear this particular costume?
They made me do it.
How did it feel when you fell?
Great. I love the snow.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, Pete Cavana. Huh? Is this good or what? Well, okay, Pete, you can take a breath now. I like that. Way to go, Pete. Pete Cavana.
Why this particular suit? You hardly have anything on. Aren't you cold?
I'm freezing my cojones off.
Mark Senfield.
How did you come up with this lovely outfit?
Well, it sort of grew over the last 28 years, you know. I just felt it coming on, and it just bursted out this afternoon.
Who's next? Graham Stimson. Stimson Beach. Graham Stimson from London, England. Pip, pip, cheerio, mate.
How'd you feel coming down the mountain?
Not bad. It's the snowballs that did it. You know, it could have been quite nasty. If something could have gone blue and dropped off.
Chris Burns is from Silverthorne, Colorado. Last year's winner. And come on, Chris, get down here. Nice suit. What is he? He's Pocahontas. Oh!
Where'd you get the other
fringe? Why
that? Christopher Flash Jacobson. Let's see it, Christopher. Flash Jacobson from Leadville, Colorado. He's a ski instructor. Who cares? He's 24 years old. Copper Mountain Looney Tunes ski instructor.
It's fun. I'm a little rusty on my ballet routine. I used to be halfway decent.
Scott Severs, come on down here. Oh. Oh, Scott's done this before. I get the feeling this guy's a pro.
My routine is rags to riches.
Okay, Steve. Steve Prokopiev. Steve Prokopiev. Oh, here it is. Look at this. Steve Prokopiev. I got that right. And that. Oh, we could do that. We don't even have to have a reason. Okay, let's hear it for Steve.
Okay, ladies and gentlemen, I know you were waiting for this. Pete Covada is the winner. Let's hear it for Pete Covada.
Copper Mountain's a great mountain. The people are great. And I had a good time. Even the snowballs were great. I wasn't wearing much. I guess they call it a G-string or a T-bag. Actually, it's kind of embarrassing. I'm glad to have my clothes back on.
Hey!
Flex. Nice. Roll around.
Keep flexing.
Turn around slowly. I'm going to direct you. You keep moving. Keep flexing. Now turn. Nice. Get down on your hands and knees and give one of these. Now what I want you to do is bring your hand, your right hand, up your body, up into your hair. Can you fall down the hill now just once? Very nice. Now give a roll down the slope. Give a nice roll. Don't stop. Keep flowing with it. Bring your hand up into your hair again. Now run up. Can you run up the hill one more time? Woo!
I love Copper Mountain. Oh, thanks, guys.
Hi, I'm Pete Cavada from Frisco, Colorado, here at Copper Mountain. I'm the winner of the Eeny Weeny Teeny Bikini Contest. Please vote for me on the Bikini Open.
I'll be your best friend.
Don't miss our next big adventure. It's showtime in Las Vegas.
Las Vegas is not real America. It's vacation town.
Las Vegas is a land. There's lots of opportunity. There are stars here. There are agents here.
There are also great bikini contests here, like the English Leather Cover Girl Challenge.
Such a nice city is Las Vegas.
In a city that's full of beautiful showgirls and glittering stages, the Miss English Leather Calendar Girl Challenge is still the hottest game in town.
I love it here. It's just fun, fun, fun.
And today's jackpot, the cover of the English Leather Calendar.
Watch for us on the Bikini Open.
Of all the luck, the Bikini Open's here in Las Vegas for the English Leather Calendar Girl Challenge.
That's right, we're here for the finals of the English Leather Cover Girl... Sorry. Cover Girl... The English Leather Calendar Challenge.
Michael, it's your lucky day.
That's right, it's our lucky day because the Bikini opens in Las Vegas for the finals of the English Leather Calendar Girl Challenge.
Stay with us.
You notice in our title, it's not a pageant. It's called the Calendar Girl Challenge. This is a challenge. To us, it's like the new pageant, let's say, of the 90s. Calendar Girl Challenge. This is a challenge. To us, it's like the new pageant, let's say, of the 90s, going into a different era, going into a new concept. And we're looking to offer many girls opportunities and to give them training and experience that they normally wouldn't get through most other structured programs.
Some people think, when they think of pageants, any kind of pageant, they think that it's
that you're not yourself, you're fake, and you're plastic for the judges. And that's not true, because the judges can see through you. If you're sincere and genuine and just being yourself, they will know if you're not.
You need somebody who is articulate. You need somebody who is believable. You need somebody who is nice. You need somebody who will keep out of trouble during the next year. You never know, you know, the judge on your left and the judge on your right, who they're going to pick. You know, it's a horse race.
We're not looking for a high fashion model. We're just looking for that all-American but sexy look.
Tell them in your eyes, tell them how you walk, tell them physical, you know, body language, that you want to win, that you want to get somewhere, that you are the one that wants to make your country proud of you.
You need to have an inside that shines outside. You have to have confidence, poise, lots of personality, and just glow.
Relax and take it for fun. The judge will know that if she work hard, I'm gonna win. They will see that, and that will not be natural. It has to be natural, I think.
I'm very happy and proud to present to you our swimsuit competition in their Missy Swimwear. Dawn Wagner. Dawn is presently a marketing promotion sales representative. Her hobbies include going to the movies, dancing, traveling, and barefoot water skiing. Diana Atkins. Diana is presently a model and owns her own consulting firm. Her hobbies include working out, playing tennis, and collecting clowns. Diana's ambition is to be an actress. Laura Ann Smith. Laura is presently a gymnastics coach. Her hobbies include performing gymnastics, dancing, and modeling. Candy Brown. Candy is presently a student majoring in psychology. Her hobbies include dancing, singing, playing saxophone, and modeling. Candy's ambition is to become a child psychologist. Colleen Carlone. Colleen is presently the operator of a boutique for a corporate building. Her hobbies include collecting dolls, reading fashion magazines, dancing, and exercising. Wendy Marie Mock. Wendy is presently a student and a model. Her hobbies include biking, dancing, skiing, cooking, and traveling. Deneen Rice. Deneen is an interior designer. She enjoys country singing, poetry, and modeling in her spare time. Marlene Quick. Marlene is currently a receptionist in her native Sweden. She enjoys running, playing the trumpet, and spending time with her dog. Rhonda Thompson. Rhonda is currently a manager at an insurance company. She enjoys playing. Rhonda is currently a manager at an insurance company. She enjoys playing softball, water skiing, and swimming.
Rhonda's primary ambition is to become a college professor. Melissa Pascu. Melissa is presently attending Cal Poly San Luis Obispo and is moving on to medical school at UCLA next year. Her hobbies include exercising, skiing, reading, and modeling. Melissa's ambition is to become a pediatrician. Kelly McCarty. Kelly is presently a student studying nutrition and is also a lifeguard. She enjoys aerobics, racquetball, swimming, and playing golf. Her ambition is to pursue a career in nutrition and science, exercise science. Her hobbies include modeling, aerobic dancing, weight training, and participating in outdoor activities. Kim Sue Malloy. Kim is presently a student and part-time model and actress. Her hobbies include modeling, swimming, playing tennis, and horseback riding. Don't they look beautiful in their swimsuits? Okay, judges, it's time to make your last decisions and get ready to hand in your ballots.
The English Leather Misty Swimwear Calendar Girl Cover Girl, Kelly McCarthy.
Yes, Kelly.
The competition was really tough, and every girl here could have been on the cover. So I feel very lucky.
It was a smile that started at her toes and came right out of her face. And she carried herself beautifully. When she walked, she glided.
I'm very proud of her. And she's a beautiful girl, but she's also has a beautiful heart.
She's very sexy looking, but she's also very cute and very wholesome looking. Originally from Liberal, Kansas. It's a small town, about 20,000 people, and I enjoy it. I'm glad I had the opportunity to grow up in a smaller place because I think the people are really genuine and they just come across real natural. I think it's important to always be yourself, and if you can't be yourself, then people are going to see right through that, and you can't be a truly good person inside and out unless you are proud of who you are and can always be yourself. I'm studying sports nutrition. I'd like to work with major league sports teams and devise exercise and nutrition programs for them. One person that I do admire is Greg Louganis, because in the past Olympics he was on the high dive and he went off and he hit his head on the lower board, and he got up and he did it again and he scored a 10. And I think anybody who can pick themselves up and go back and try it again is just someone to truly admire. And I think those are words to live by. Always just pick yourself up and just keep going. Hi, I'm Kelly McCarty. I'm from Wichita, Kansas. Vote for me on the Bikini Open.
This is some adventure!
I've got my thrill cam, parasail cam ready with me, ready to go up. We're going to get a bird's eye view from up there. So here we go, it's an ultimate adventure. Woo! great. Really feel like a bird up here. This is fantastic. This is really an ultimate adventure. Everybody should try parasailing. It's a lot of fun. Hi, down there. Okay, I'm now going to try and take a close-up of myself. Hi. Hi up there. I'm now up in the parasail. This is the ultimate adventure. This is great. Can you see my parasail right above? There's my crew on the boat. Woo! God, the wind is really hitting up here. Whoa! You can see me with the thrill cam. It's the ultimate adventure up here. Oop, there are my feet. Okay, I'm coming in for my landing. There's the dock. Hi, guys. Oh, I want to come down now because I'm getting dizzy. Bring me back. Okay, bring me down. Bring me down. Next, we're sailing off to sunny Los Angeles, California.
Yeah, for a great bikini contest.
The contest goes fantastically every year. This is the 8th year. The bikini contest has been filmed, and it's available on video through California Classic Clips and Diamond Bar. Basically, it's done that way so that the people who don't get to see it live can see it live in their own home. It works out great.
Okay, we are here in Anaheim, California at Oscars Nightclub for the Oscars Miss California Girl Bikini Contest. It's unbelievable. This is unbelievable. Let's go check it out now. Why did you come to this contest tonight?
The women, what else?
Dream girls. The kind we all wish we could get a little piece of, but...
I came here to meet my future ex-wife.
What's your ideal woman that you think you'll see here tonight?
Oh, gorgeous blonde, nice boobs, nice rear end, you know.
About 130 pounds, 40-inch boobs, with a gold American Express card.
Blonde, blue-eyed, great personality, boobs. That'd do it.
What type of image are you trying to portray when you're out there?
Well, I have different images. One's kind of sexy, and one is real fun and real bubbly.
Look nice, but nasty, and they called it nice-y.
I'm very sexy, and everybody likes me for being sexy, but I try to portray that, but I'm like...
I don't want to just go out there and shake around. I want to dance well, you know, and I want people to say, oh, you know, she's really talented.
And what are you going to do to turn the crowd on?
Show my tits.
Just smile a lot. You know, I think that your personality really comes through, and I think they appreciate that more than...
You, like, suck them in really slow. You're really seductive, and then you, like, slam them, and then they're on your side.
What do you do besides bikini contests?
I do some modeling the other day and watch soap operas.
Well, actually, during the day, I'm a very good girl, and I work at a hospital. You can believe that.
And what do you think about this, about the California Bikini Contest?
You know, you have to put forth 110% when it's a competition like this.
Stiff competition tonight. I think it's the best thing in the world.
Come on, noisemakers!
These are the best of the best, gentlemen. This is the finals. This is the one that's world famous. You were here. You can lie about this for years. In the meantime, be prepared to get crazy. This is contestant number one. This is Karen. This is the mellow part of the competition. That's right. This is the calm, sedate part, the part we show on the Sesame Street show. If you're ready, I want you to give her a warm round of applause. Here comes Lee. I want you to reach way down in the heart of your bottom and make a lot of screaming primal noises for contestant number three. This is Christy. So we don't get this on the Disney Channel, all right? In fact, it is time for you to start screaming like you are from California, all right? Do us proud. For contestant number five, this is Marissa. Marissa. Contestant number six is ready to come out. Contestant number six, this is Michelle. Michelle. If you're ready, then I want you to applaud like you've never applauded before. Come on, make some noise. Here she comes. This is Brandy. Here comes contestant number eight. And again, it is time for you to motivate this young lady with a loud round of applause. Are you ready? Here comes Bridget. Here comes Bridget. All right, here we go with contestant number nine. I think you're warmed up. Come on for contestant number nine. This is Julie. Julie. What do you guys like, redheads? Come on. Here we go with contestant number 10. This is Pamela. Pamela. All this crowd out here is going, oh. Contestant number 12 is ready to come out here. This is Dana. Dana. Put your hands together for contestant number 13. Very good. Here she comes. This is Tiffany Ann. Tiffany Ann. After this small break, we are going to have the killer part of this contest. This is the one that would give a dead man a hard on.
Here I am one more time with my bikini open earmuffs, and boy do I love this. I'm having the time of my life. I wish you guys are here out there with me. And oh my god, oh my god, let's go check out the contest.
$1,000 in cash. The new champion of the Miss California Bikini Girl competition went to contestant number 13, Tiffany Ann. Tiffany Ann!
How do you feel, Tiffany?
I feel fabulous!
I would say that I'm a cute person. I'm very strong, very independent, and I usually say what's on my mind as long as I can say it in a way that's not going to hurt someone else's feelings. When I was growing up, I was very ugly. I was a tomboy. I hated girls, couldn't stand them. Just let me hang around with boys in my jeans and climb trees, and I never wore makeup. You never saw me in a dress. I hated dresses. I don't think I started becoming feminine till I was 19. My long-term goal is to be a police officer, and I would like to work with abused children of drug addicts, you know, showing them that there is something better in America besides drugs. I like a man who is romantic. I want someone who's really sincere, who's honest about their feelings, who's open. A man who can talk about their feelings is like God's gift to women.
Hi, my name's Tiffany Ann. I'm from Los Angeles, California. Please vote for me in the Bikini Open.
Just from Quebec City, Canada. Vote for me in the Bikini Open.
Hi, I'm Steve Harbison. Vote for me on the Bikini Open. Thank you.
Hi, I'm Pete Cavada from Frisco, Colorado, here at Copper Mountain. I'm the winner of the Eeny Weeny Teeny Bikini Contest. Please vote for me on the Bikini Open. I'll be your best friend.
Hi, I'm Catherine Calafiore, and please vote for me for the Bikini Open.
Hi, I'm Gail McKenna from Liverpool, England. Vote for me on the Bikini Open.
Hi, my name is Leslie Bremer. I'm from Ramona, California, and I hope you vote for me for the Bikini Open.
Hi, I'm Kelly McCarty. I'm from Wichita, Kansas. Vote for me on the Bikini Open.
Hi, my name is Tiffany Ann. I'm from Los Angeles, California. Please vote for me in the Bikini Open.
I'm Doug.
Thank you.
Towson State University, it's Pamela Paulshock.
Had the best bathing suit, I thought, and her body was just, you know, the best. She was really, really good looking.
And Pamela was the best. I'm happy for her. Pamela, I wish you the best, and I think you're a very beautiful girl.
She won by a landslide.
I was just thrilled to death that I won. I mean, I couldn't believe it. I was so excited. I had no idea, no clue, even watching the other girls, I mean, they were gorgeous. They're all beautiful girls, and they had great personalities. Each one of them deserved to win. We just had the best time, and we didn't even really feel that it was such a contest to who was going to win. We felt that, you know, it really didn't matter who won. When we got together out in New York, we ran, like, all over the place, saw everything, like Empire State Building, and Trump Towers and Trump Plaza. We had a great time. Went shopping, spent lots and lots of money, bought lots and lots of clothes. But we had a great time. I'd just like to thank all the Bikini Open 2 viewers out there who voted for me, giving me the opportunity to have the most wonderful experience I've ever had. I'll never forget it. Thank you. In the Bikini Open 3, I wish them the best of luck. They'll have a great time, lots of fun, and it'll be a great experience for them. Best of luck and congratulations to the winner.
Bikini Open guy. From San Diego, California, it's number 2, Steve Harvester. Gentlemen, the moment you've all been waiting for, your favorite Bikini Open girl,
From Brentwood, California, it's number 5, Tiffany Ann Johnson.
Congratulations going out to our winners.
We've had a great time on Bikini Open 3.
It's been the ultimate adventure.
See you at Bikini Open 4.
Bye.